Hello, everybody. It's me, Nina West, and I want you to go big, be kind, and go code? Just kidding. It's actually me, Analytical, showing off the new website we're going to be building today. We've got some augmented reality, putting Nina's face on top of ours. We have a few fun options.
Looks like things just got a legendary.
It follows my face around and even can do mood detection, so when I smile, it shows me smiling. Alright, I'm Analytical. Welcome to this tutorial. Today we're going to build the fun Nina West augmented reality, virtual reality, whatever you want to call it, Snapchat filter effect website. I think it is so fun, so cool. I just showed you a demo of it. If you think it's cool, be sure to leave a like on the video, subscribe, ring the bell to be notified of all the upcoming content. I've got some really fun computer science, interesting problems we're gonna solve in fun ways with drag, problems you've seen, so be sure to stay tuned for that. But right now, we're gonna build this website all to show support of the queen we just lost from RuPaul's Drag Race, Nina West. She was eliminated, but that doesn't mean we have to stop thinking about her and the amazing message of kindness she was spreading. I was so sad when she went home, so I wanted to make this website just dedicated to her. We're gonna be doing a bit of machine learning today. We've got our JavaScript, HTML, and CSS as usual, and we're gonna even touch on the HTML canvas. As always, this will be very beginner friendly, so if you haven't done any of this, it'll be great to join in. The problem we're gonna look at today is, can we look at someone's web camera in the browser, detect where their face is and even their expression, then put a new face on top of that? And this is something you see in so many fun apps. Their Snapchat is really big with it right now. They're doing all this face morphing, and you can even kind of do drag this way. So this is like a low-tech version of it, but I don't want to look more feminine or more masculine. I want to look more Nina Westian, if that's even a thing. So how do we start to break down this problem? And the first thing we can do is say, how can we detect where someone's face is in an image or a video coming from their web camera that's all happening within the browser? My first thought was to go to TensorFlow.js. This is a machine learning platform for JavaScript. So TensorFlow is a machine learning product, and then JS is for JavaScript. So actually we want to go to the JS website, and this has lots of information about how you train and do machine learning in the browser. When I'm first trying to learn how to use a new tool, I love to go check out the demos to see what kind of features do they have, and is this going to do what I need it to do? So we can check out some of these demos. I think this one is pretty cool. It lets you play Pac-Man just using your webcam. We're going to come and just use the web camera on here. So what you do is for up, left, right, and down, you're gonna make some kind of face, and that will determine where the Pac-Man will go. So for up, we'll go like this, and you just click and hold in the square to give it some training models, and then for left, let's go like this, and then right, we'll go like this, and then down. And then we click train model, so this is gonna teach this game to know when we're making this kind of face or when we're doing this kind of image, what should it react with? And a model is just a function. And we've worked with functions before. This model is going to be a function that takes an image and tries to give us a label for this image. So if we're like this, we'd like the output to be left. So to train the model, we need to give it a bunch of examples. So these examples are a group of images and labels for them all. So let's see if this game works now with just using my face. No hands. All right, well, I didn't do so hot on this, but this is still really cool. And definitely the right and left are working a lot better than the up and down. Okay, so let's close this example out. And I dug around on here, and it seemed like they had some stuff that would work with a camera, but it didn't seem super easy to use. So I'm gonna discover this thing called Face API, and it was doing exactly what I wanted. So in this first example, they have a photo, and they detect where everyone's face is in. This is like the cast of the Big Bang Theory. Ew, nerds. Who'd wanna be a nerd? It's able to recognize where their faces are, and then we can even click detect face landmarks, and it will draw on where their brows are, their eyes, nose, lips, and even their jaw. And we're really getting a lot of information here. It can also do face recognition, so it's able to determine which person matches to which person in another image. So like when we did with the Pac-Man example where we said, this is going to be right, we'd give them a bunch of examples of all the people in the Big Bang Theory cast and label them. We train that model, and then it would be able to predict on a new image who's who in the image. And here we see it knows this is person two and this is person two, even though the facial hair is different. But what I was really looking for was webcam face expression recognition. And here we are, here's my face again. So it's able to see where my face is and is drawing this rectangle around, so that's great. Now I can make certain faces. Because of all my drag and makeup, it probably is a little confused about my expressions. But let's try to be neutral and then excited and happy. We're going to go ahead and use this. So I went to go look at the GitHub, which is where they store all the information about this code. Now we see it shows those examples of detecting where the parts of the face are, or drawing the face on and making predictions. And it shows us the feature. So we do the face recognition, the landmark detection, so where the eyes, jaw, etc. are, and then the expression recognition, age estimation, gender recognition. Let me leave a comment below if you think we should try and play with this and see if we can fool it and see if we can have some fun with this. Let me know. And that shows how to run the examples. And if we want to run it from the browser, so face API.js for the browser, we just have to include this JavaScript file. So I've gone ahead and already packaged the JavaScript file up and all of the machine learning models that it's created for you, as well as any faces and sounds that we're going to use in this project. Go grab the samples from the description, and then we're just going to start out with that. And open all of these in Sublime, and we can see what we've got. I've gone ahead and set up all the HTML we're going to need for this, setting up the camera stream, even if the camera doesn't work, and some of those mood detection buttons. We're not going to focus on that at all this episode. We're just going to import this script.javascript, and I also have some style.css that we've included. Feel free to poke around this if you want to learn more. And in the script, I even did a bunch for you already. I've already set up a function that will set up the camera input and look for the faces, and it runs this 10 times every second. So we just want to implement the draw face function, and that gets called in the look for faces. So here we see draw face, and we don't have to worry about it. Feel free to go in, dive around, look at that code. I left comments there so you can understand what's going on, but I just want to focus on how do we draw these faces. Like with last time, we're going to need to open our terminal and set up the live server using Node. And this is just a one-line Node command. If you haven't used the command line or terminal before, don't worry. I'll link to my previous video where I show the one-minute setup for how to download the live server application, and you can just use that. So go do that and then come right back. We're going to change into the directory that has all these files. So I guess this is GoSpace2 because I already was playing around with the first one. And then we're just going to start live-server to start our live server. And that's all we need to do in the command line for this episode. So we're going to have it pop up everything that I've done so far. So instead of the camera, I added the CSS already. No need to worry about it. The first thing we should try to do is draw a box around our face as it moves around. We'll do this with the HTML canvas. I created an overlay and using CSS to make it the same shape and size of our video box. And the HTML canvas is the suggested tool for drawing on anything like this. So the overlay is all the way from here to here, and up and down. So we're going to use HTML Canvas to draw on this. And if you're unfamiliar with HTML Canvas, you can just go to W3Schools and get the information. But the most basic thing we're going to do is for HTML drawing, we looked up, and we want to draw on the canvas. So looks like to draw a rectangle, we might use the fill rect command, or I looked up a little bit, and we're going to use the stroke rect command so that it's just the box and isn't filled in. And here we pass in the X, Y, width, and height. We can try to change any of these around, so 10, or we run that, now it's skinny, and the upper left-hand corner of the box is 0, 0. So here we have to get the canvas context, so here we called it canvas context, and we're going to set the stroke style equal to red, and I'll just set the color stroke width equal to 3 for 3 pixels, and then canvas context dot stroke rect equal to 0, 0, offset width, and then maybe 10. Now we know how to draw a box on the screen. We want to set this to 100 and even like 10, 10. It's going to be on the opposite side just because of the mirroring I'm doing for the web camera. So what we want to do here is get the box that's surrounding our face. And that information is contained in this detections object. So the best way to find out what's inside of that is just to do a console.log detections. So we'll save this again and we'll refresh the page to this live server. We can inspect because we want to see what's inside of this. So it's doing it again, 10 times every second, so we scroll up a little bit, it'll stop scrolling so quickly. Then we can go in here. So this is the face detection object. And there's a lot of scary stuff in here, but don't worry. We see there's the image height, image width, and we're just looking for the box. So we can click into the box, and it has the X, Y, and width and height. So those are all the variables we need for that. Let's set the box equal to detections.box. And then we'll set the X, the Y, width, and the height. And just to set these all quickly, I'm going to hold Alt and drag my cursor down to select every line. And I can select all these variables at once, make them equal to box, dot, and then I did a copy and a paste. So now it's all in there. And then instead of putting the rectangle on this random place, we're going to put it in the X, Y position of our face and make it the width and height that it detected as well. So X, Y, width, and height. And it's drawing the box around my face. And it even follows as I move. Although, you'll probably notice it keeps drawing boxes all over my face. And we don't want it to be covered up. I didn't spend hours painting this iffy mug to be covered up. So we're just going to run the command canvas context.clearRect. And this is going to draw a rectangle that will clear part of the screen. So this is just like the stroked rect. We need to pass in an X, a Y, and then for the width and height, we'll just use canvas width and canvas height. And let's see if this is better. And it takes a second just to load in that model. And it seems like it's working. Every time I move around, the box follows with me and it shakes a little bit, but this is basically what we were looking for. Instead of drawing the box, you really want to draw an image. So there's this whole page about canvas images, and it looks like there's this command draw image. And it takes in the same parameters that stroked rect does. So it has an X and a Y. And just from some research I know, you can take in the width and the height if you want to distort the image to fit into the size that we're specifying. Now we can do canvas draw image. We'll want to put an image in there, and then we can copy in the other variable. So we can just create a new image here. And then we have to set the source equal to one of the images I have. I'm feeling my Nina West fantasy, honey. Okay, let me comment this out. I also just realized we've been working with const and let this episode. These are just an alternative way to say var. So instead of var box equals detection box, we're saying const. And if you use const, you can't reassign it. So box equals whatever. We wouldn't be able to do this because it's a constant, so you just can't rename it. So it's a little tool that helps make the program more optimal. If we change the const to let though, then it will work. By default, you could make everything let and it wouldn't really be too much of an issue, but if you know you're not going to change those variables, if you're setting them only once, go for const and it'll make your program a little bit better. And recomment this in. Why don't we even change this to see if it's working for another image? These are looking a little bit small. So I think in my final example, I ended up scaling them up a little bit. So let's do that too. So I think what we'll do is make it 2 times the width and 2 times the height, and then see if that looks good. So the size is good, but now it's a little bit off center. So I did some math to figure out where we need to change the X and the Y, and we just need to do minus the width divided by 4 and minus the height divided by 4. And if you want to change these numbers, feel free to play around with them. If you want to make it smaller or bigger or add your own images that are going to fit. I'm sorry, I'm not going to be able to take myself seriously if I keep drawing these images of Nina filled with joy over my face. We don't want to be just showing only one face. We want to be able to detect your mood from the image, from this webcam, like we had in that other example. And we want to see, can we change the face we're displaying based on the mood you're showing in the camera? So that's what's in this expressions input. So this function takes in two inputs. It takes the detections, which we've already worked with, and then expressions. Why don't we log out to see what's in the expressions? And it looks like we're getting an array of objects of expressions. The first one we see is neutral. It has the name neutral and it has a value. And this value is a prediction of how confident it is that your expression is this expression. And all these numbers should add up to 100. The expression we want to show is going to be the one that has the highest value. So how would we find the highest value of this array of objects? It might be easier for you as a human to look at it and see, okay, well, let's see which one looks the biggest. You can maybe think about them all at once and then just pick which is the biggest. But a computer can't do that. So how do we communicate to a computer, find the max in this list? Why don't we write a new function here? And we can call it getExpression. And this will take in the expression, and then we want it to return the name of the expression. So in this case, we want it to return sad, because that's the expression it thinks my face is displaying. So how might we think about to tell a computer to do this? Maybe we go through and compare each one. So we take the first one and say, this is our max value for now. Then we look at the next one and say, is this value greater than that? And if so, then make that the next value. And then we'll go through them. So why don't we write this out in pseudocode? So this is just not real code. We could write it in a comments. It'll basically tell us, here's the algorithm we're trying to write. Here's the problem we're trying to solve with code. Look at initial value, compare to next value. If next value is more, that to current max. Repeat this for all values. So this is our algorithm. Now we just need to write this out. Create a variable current max, and we can set this equal to expressions zero. So this is the first element. We're doing this for all values, so let's do a loop. And as a reminder of how to loop through an array, we do for let I equal 0, while I is less than the length of the expressions, increment I. To get the value of the expression we're at, we do expressions in square brackets I. And to get the value of it, we just do dot value. Now we're trying to do this comparison. So if current max dot value is greater than expression dot value, or rather we want to check if the new value is greater than that, then we'll set the current max equal to the expression that we're currently at, that we're currently looping through, that we're currently iterating through, all the same. Here we want to return the current max, or to make it even more simple, we can just return the current max dot expression. And why don't we log out the get expression function, just so we can do a bit of manual debugging to see if it's working the way we intended to. Seems like I'm happy, it detects I'm happy. Now we have to figure out, what are we gonna do with this? Here, why don't we set expression equals get expression expressions. Wow, this is a lot of expressions. I just wanted to talk about my feelings. Now we need to take the set of images that we have that align with certain emotions we want to display, then select one of those images based on the expression we find. I've already actually created this array of the images. I have the names of the files, and then I'm running this map command on it. This is really just a shorthand version of doing a for loop over this array. This is what it's doing really under the hood, iterating through the entire list of faces we gave it, and then it stores the value as the source, because if we're gonna modify it, we would lose that information. Then we'll update that to be a new image, and we can't do this all in one go, just because of what this image function allows us to do. Unlike the audio function where we set it all in one go, and then we're good. A little annoying, but we're working with what we're working with. Set the new image, and then we update the source to be the source we want. It's always good to know what's happening when you're calling a function like this, because you can call a map, and that's just one line, but really, there's a lot more. There's a whole for loop happening under the hood. So here we have the list of faces. Grab one from Nina Faces. God damn it, Nina, you funny lady. You funny lady. Okay, so now we want to find the expression that matches it. So like map, there's actually a function we can run on this called find. Here we pass it another function, and we need to pass in the face, and we can call this anything really. We call it F, we call it Nina Face. We can just call it face even, because that'll be the easiest. And that's the equivalent of doing Nina faces I, if we're in a for loop context. Find the face where the name of that file, so here we have all these files, angry, disgusted, fearful, these are the names of the expressions, where face.source, that includes the text we have in expression. And we're returning this. So the one where it matches, it will return true, and the ones where it doesn't, it will return false, and then we'll be left with one image. And if there were multiple, I believe it would return the first element it found. Why don't we see if this works now? And I guess I can do a side-by-side if this is... I said we're neutral. Surprised. Angry. Maybe I'll remove the glasses to see if that helps. That's happy. Angry. That's my favorite, going from the shocked face to the angry face. I think it's just such a funny transition. Okay. Throwing back my glasses on so I can continue to code and educate the children. So in my final example, I did realize that the flashing was getting a little much. I set up a mode where you could enable mood detection if you chose to. But otherwise, if you just clicked on one of these images, you'd get the sound and you'd get the face with the image. And this is all copied from the soundboard tutorial I did. All right, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you got to enjoy building this website with me, getting to learn a few cool things about machine learning, augmented reality, HTML canvas. If any of these things are really interesting to you and you'd like me to do a video separately solely on that, let me know and I'll do some research and I'll create a video. I have some big plans for June. I want to create a computer science curriculum for you all so you can learn more, so you can solve really good problems with code and be prepared. If you want to go to college in code, or if you want to go to a coding bootcamp, or you want to get a computer science or computer engineering job, I want to be able to teach you those skills that you're going to need. So stay tuned for all of that. Right now, be sure to watch my videos, share the content, love it all. Thank you so much. And adventure is out there. Go big, be kind. Go fucking west. Bye, everybody.